नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ह्लादेकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. सो वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् वाक्यमात्रदोषाः. वि हेड् लुक्ड् एट् विसन्धि लास्ट् क्लास्. Visleshya-rupah. So visandhi is of three types. One is Visleshya-rupah. The second one is Ashlilatvam. The third is Kashtatvam. And in Visleshya-rupah, he gave us three examples. And further divisions are Aichikah, Pragrahya-hetukah, and Asiddhi-hetukah, Anushasanikah. Where Aichikah is the Kavi, according to his wishes, he can make the sandhi or not. But in a padyam, it gives a bandha dardhyam, that is, there is a tightness to the rhythm if the sandhi is done properly. And if the sandhi is not done, there is a bandha shaitilyam, and hence it is a dosha. Pragrihya hetuka and asiddhi hetuka are all anushasanikaha, which is it follows the anushasanam or Panini's grammar rules. There are two rules. One is pragrihyam, which is prakriti bhava sandhi, and the other is asiddhi hetukam, where the sandhi cannot happen because of an earlier sutra which is applied. In both cases, if it is too much, then it is a difficult. If there are one or two occurrences, then it is okay. It is not a dosha. If there are many occurrences, then it is considered as a dosha. So we saw the Visleshya Rupam. The next is Ashlilatvam and Kashtatvam. He gives two examples. One is for Ashlilatvam. The next is for Kashtatvam. Vegad uddiya gagane chalan damara cheshtitaha ayamuttapate patri tataha atraiva ruchin kuru. Now, in both cases, first let me say the meaning of the shlokam. Ayam patri vegad uddiya gagane chalan damara cheshtitaha uttapate. Ayam patri damara cheshtitaha patri. So there is a someone who wants to, or you can say Naika, Nayaka, or a Sakhi, two friends are talking, and one girl is saying to the other girl, don't go to that place. A bird is flying in that place, and it is making a huge noise there, and it is also flying, fluttering around. So don't go there. Why don't you just stay here? So ayam patri, this bird, vegat uddiya, it is flying with the speed, out of speed, and then gagane chalanne, it goes to the akasham, akashe dayanne, damara cheshtitaha, it just makes a very, one minute, let me show. For damara cheshtitaha, he gives a very damaram udbhatam means excessive movement. So it is fluttering around here and there, that is damara cheshtitaha. So damaram is also called damaru vadyam, tadvat cheshtitam iti damara cheshtitam. So damaruhu yatha shabdam karoti tatha patri khagaha api shabdam karoti tadrisham damara cheshtitam karoti patri. So ayam patri vegat uddiya gagane chalan damara cheshtitaha uttapate, it is creating a ruckus in that place. Tataha tasmat karanat atraiva ruchim kuru tatra magaccha atraiva ruchim kuru. So this is the shloka. He gives an example. So chalane damaraha and ruchim kuru, those are the two words which have been combined into sandhi. The sutra that is applicable here is yaro anunasike anunasiko va, is the sutra that is applied here. It's what I remember. He doesn't mention it in the vyakhyana, but yeah, if the anunasika follows दट् इस् चलन् इस् अ नकारान्त दन्त्य अनुनासिकं दन्त्यनासिक लेटर् एण्ड् इट् इस् फालोड् बै ड सो इट् आटोमेटिक्लि इस् रीप्लेस्ड् बै दि नासिका आफ् द टवर्ग दट् इट् फालोस् द वर्ग लेटर् दट् इट् फालोस् इट् टेक्स् द नासिका लेटर् आफ् दट् वर्ग सो इन्स्टेड् आफ् न यु चेञ्ज् इट् टु ण मूर्धन्य ण द सेम् वे रुचिं कुरु दि अनुस्वार इस् चेञ्ज्ड् इन् टु ngakara, which is the nasika of the kavarga, which is the kanthya nasika. So ruchim kuru has been changed to ruching kuru. That is how you have to pronounce in shlokas. You never say vegaduddiya gagane chalan damara cheshtitaha. Vegaduddiya gagane chalan damara cheshtitaha. Ayam uttapate patri tato atreiva ruchim kuru. That's the way you have to pronounce, and that is the ease of pronunciation for which the sandhi has been used. Here the problem is the words landa and chinku are in deshiya bhasha. In dialects, it is representative of the private parts, and hence it is an ashlilatvam, it is a jugupsa. Ashlilatvam means asabhyatvam, uncultured way of expression, which also induces disgust in the person who hears it. Next is kashtatvam. Urvyasavatra tarvali marvante charvavasthitihi. Let me check what he has given in the vritti. Atra sandhau ashlilata. That's all Mamata has mentioned. So sandhau ashlilata kutra chalanne damara ityatra sandhau ashlilata. तथा रुचिं कुरु इत्यत्रापि रुचिं कुरु इति सन्धौ अपि अश्लीलत्वं वर्तते. द नेक्स्ट् वन् ही डजन्ट् गिव् एनी वृत्ति फोर् दट्. ओके, सो उर्वि असौ अत्र तर्वालि मरुवन्ते चार्ववस्थितिः नात्रर्जु युज्यते गन्तुं शिरोनमय तन्मनाक्. So at the end of a desert, so the same, you can use the same situation that is there for the earlier shloka also, where there are two friends who are talking and one friend is asking another person to go to a shady place. Marvante atra maruvante maroho ante marudeshasya antima bhage. So until that part it is a desert, and then at the bordering the desert there is a row of trees which is giving shade, and it's very beautiful there. It is very calm. So it's a nice place to come and sit down. So in order to invite someone else to that place, he is saying, Atra maru ante, maru pradeshasya antime bhage, charu avastitihi urvi, urvi bhumihi, charu avastitihi sundarataya vartate. भूमेः अवस्थितिः स्थितिः द सिचुएशन् आफ् दि अर्थ् इन् दिस् पोर्शन् एट् दि एण्ड् आफ् द डेसर्ट् इस् वेरि ब्यूटिफुल्. असौ तर्वाली च तरु आली तर्वाली तरूणाम् आली तरूणां पङ्क्तिः अत्र तरूणां पङ्क्तिरपि अस्ति अतः चारु अवस्थितिः उर्वी. सो दिस् प्लेस् इस् गाट् वेरि ब्यूटिफुल् अम्बियन्स् तस्मात् न अत्र ऋजु युज्यते गन्तुं. न देर् इस् एट् दि एण्ड् आफ् डेसर्ट् मीन्स् यु डोण्ट् हेव् टाल् ट्रीस् आर् एनिथिङ्ग्. देर् मे बि बुशस् वित् ओवर् हेङ्गिङ्ग् ब्रान्चस् एण्ड् एव्रिथिङ्ग्. सो यु सेयिङ्ग् सिन्स् देर् आर् अ लाट् आफ् ट्रीस् वित् ब्रान्चस् यु केनाट् गो स्ट्रेट्, यु हेव् टु बेण्ड् डौन् अ लिटिल् बिट् एण्ड् गो. दट्स् आल् द श्लोका इस् नाट् अ वेरि difficult or a great shloka. Na atra ruju yujyate gantum, natrarju yujyate gantum, na atra ruju yujyate gantum, tat shiraha manak namaya. So slowly, little bit, you have to bend your head down and go. Ruju, ruju is straight. You can't stand straight and go. गन्तुं न युज्यते, इट् इस् नाट् प्रापर् फार् यू टु स्टाण्ड् स्ट्रेट् अण्ड् गो. तत् तस्मात् कारणात् मनाक् ईषत् शिरः नमय. सो बेण्ड् युर् हेड् अ लिटिल् बिट् अण्ड् गो. सो हियर् एव्री प्लेस् यु फैण्ड् देट् सन्धिवशात् देर् इस् अ कष्टत्वं. कष्टत्वम् इस् ओन्लि श्रुति कटु, नाट् बिकास् आफ् द लेटर्स् दट् इस् बीङ्ग् यूस्ड्, बट् बिकास् आफ् द सन्धि दट् इस् बीङ्ग् डन् इन् द पद्यम. सो उर्वी प्लस असौ उर्व्यसौ, दैट्स द संधि देयर. ई हैज बिकम य, इको यणचि इज द संधि. द सेम तरुवाली, मर्वन्ते, एवरीवेयर यू विल फाइंड दैट द उ हैज बीन रिप्लेस्ड बाय व. इन तरुवाली, मर्वन्ते एंड चार्ववस्थितिः. इन उर्व्यसौ द ईकार हैज बीन रिप्लेस्ड बाय इय. नात्रर्जु अगेन इज इट इज अ ऋकार हैज बीन चेंज्ड. इन इको यणचि इफ यू फाइंड इ उ ऋ ल आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय य र ल य व र ल व्हेन फॉलोड बाय अच. All the letter, when it is followed by the letters of ach, i.e. all the vowels, the preceding letters of e, u, r, l are replaced by y, v, r and l. Okay. Now, it follows rules, it follows Panini rules, that is not an issue. But when you try to recite the shloka, उर्व्यसा वत्र तर्वाली मर्वन्ते चार्ववस्थितिः, यू आर ट्राइंग टू से टेल समवन दैट दिस प्लेस हियर इज सो ब्यूटिफुल, प्लीज कम एंड स्टे हियर एंड यू नो बाउ डाउन योर हेड अ लिटिल बिट एंड कम हियर. व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू डिस्क्राइब अ प्लेस व्हिच इज ब्यूटिफुल, यू कांट यूज सच हार्श संधि व्हिच मेक्स इट वेरी हार्श टू द इयर्स. So kashtatvam is the dosham here, and that is visandhi. Sandehe vairupye kashtatvam is the classification of that visandhi dosha. So we've looked at visandhi. Now if you look at the vakyamatra doshaha, we have looked at pratikula varnatvam, upahata visargatvam, lupta visargatvam and visandhi. Now we move on to hatavrittatvam. Hatavrittatvam, there are about three different types that he mentions. So he says hatam lakshananusarane api ashravyam aprapta guru bhava anta laghu rasa ananugunam cha vrittam yatra tat hatavrittam kramena udaharanam. Here hatam, which means the vrittam, is not lakshana anusarane api. That api is included to show that lakshana ananusarane api. Even if it is if it does not follow the vritta lakshanam, you have a particular meter and every meter has its own definition, and you have to write padyas and shlokas according to that definition. Now here lakshana anusaranam na karoti, that is given, that is a granted thing that it is a dosha yuktam. Now even if it is, if it follows lakshana, where all can a dosha arise? So lakshana anusarane api ashravyam is the first type. The second one is aprapta guru bhava anta laghu. The third type is rasa ananugunam. It gives an example for each and every one. I need to give you a short a crash course on what vrittam is. Otherwise, it is difficult to understand all of the different examples that he takes. So this, the first thing that we need to know as far as vrittam goes is a padyam, you always look at the number of vowels that are there in a padyam, in a shloka. You take that shloka and you look at the vowels. So each vowel is taken as, say, one varna. So there are two types of vrittam. One is chandas, one is matra vrittam, and the other is varna vrittam. For both, there is something called ganas. So let us look at the gana, and then I will go into the difference between matra vrittam and varna vrittam. So for ganas, you look at the vowels of a padyam first, and you number. Them 1 2 3 4 whatever, number them and pramattah. It is the first shloka in Megha Sandesham. So kaschit kanta viraha guruna swadhikara pramattah. If we are looking at that shlokam, kaschit if you look at that, you have only two vowels, so there are only two letters to be considered. So ka, where there is an a there, chit, where there is an ikara, so those are the two things. So kas chit kanta viraha, you have to count like that. That is for varnavrittam, and combine it into threes. So each three, you can have a combination of laghu guru, laghu guru. Laghu is letters which are hraswa, those vowels which are hraswa, and if they are also, if they are not followed by a samyuktakshara, all hraswa letters are named as laghu. And those are guru, are all dirgha letters are guru, and the hraswa letters which are followed by a samyuktakshara are considered as guru. Okay, now this is your basic rule. So each letter, for example, kaschit kanta, kaschit, that akara in the first beginning of ka, that a actually is followed by ish, ich, it's a samyuktakshara. Hence, in kaschit, the first vowel a, hraswa, is considered as guru. Kaschit kanta, viraha guruna. So kanta, kanta, viraha, ta is also dirgham, so it is considered guru. Viraha, everything, each one of those is a hraswa letter. Each one is considered as a laghu. Now, this is the aphorism that you take in order to understand what each gana is. So if you look at the first three letters of kaschit kanta, so you have three gurus there. The sutra that you have to think, you always have to have in mind is Yamata Raja Bhanasa Laga. In that, you look at which has three guru, which is the ma. Each one is a gana here. You take it as ya gana. If it is ya gana, then it has one hraswa and two dirgha. Ma gana has one dirgha. So one dirgha and ya has one laghu, two guru. Ma has three guru, ma gana. Ta gana will be the next three. Ta, ra, ja. This is how you remember each one. Then the sa gana is this. Why he has used la is laghu, ga is guru. It can end with that. This is your basic, the definition for ganas. This is what you use to understand the ganas. Now, if it does not follow the vrittam, when he gives the definition for a vrittam, he will use these ganas and give the definition. Now, vritta lakshanam na anusarati, that is a given. If it does not follow the vritta lakshanam that is given in Vritta Ratnakara or Chandomanjari or Shrutabodham, any other text that you may find, if it does not follow any lakshanam that is given, then it is a dosha yuktam padyam. The next one is vrittasya lakshanam anusarati tathapi ashravyam. That is what we are going to look at, where he gives us two examples. One is yati bhangat varnavritte ashravyam, guna vishesha yogat, gana vishesha yogat ashravyam. Okay. These are the two examples that he is giving. Yati. What is a yati? Let's look at the shlokam and then you will know the yati. Now here the first example he gives is, takes his harini vrittam. Amritam amritam kasandeho madhuni api na anyatha madhuram adhikam chutasya api prasannarasam phalam sakritapi punar madhyastasan rasantara vijjanaha vadatu yadiha anyat swadusyat priya dashana chadat. Let's look at the meaning of the shlokam. So it is about someone who is he likes women or he likes his beloved, and he is saying that kissing her or priya dashana chada, he likes kissing her, and he says that is the most sweetest thing in the world. There are so many sweet things. Amritam amritam kasandehaha, amritam, nectar is amritam, swadhu eva. The second amrita is actually, it does not mean amritam amritam, it's not a dosham here. Amritam अमृतम् अस्ति इत्युक्ते स्वाधु अस्ति और् स्वाधिष्ठम् अस्ति, कः सन्देहः? वाट् इस् देर् इस् नो डौट् अबौट् दट्, मधून्यपि न अन्यथा, मधूनि अपि स्वाधु अमृतम्. सो मधु इस् आल्सो नेक्टर् इस् आल्सो वेरि स्वीट् न अन्यथा, नोबडि इस् डिनैङ्ग् दट्. Each one has its own taste and its own sweetness. So amritam amritam kas sandehah, madhuni api na anyatha. There is nothing other which I cannot say that madhu is not sweet. So it is also sweet. Maduram adhikam chutasya api prasannarasam phalam, chutasya phalam. To amrafalam yata asti tasya prasanna rasam. If the, you know, there are many types of mangoes and some mangoes have a very distinct rasam, it is very sweet and it's very quick to take the rasam from the mango. So madhuram adhikam, so amrafalasya tu madhu apekshaya adhikam madhuram vartate. Sakridapi punaha madhyastaha sanna rasantara vijjanaha. Now I understand that there are different madhu vishayah in the world, but rasantara vit janaha, rasa antara vit janaha, raseshu bhedaha yaha vetti tas saha janaha. Rasa antara, difference, the difference between rasa, a person who understands the difference between rasa. Sakritapi, for once, madhyastaha san, let he be neutral and tell, vadatu yat iha anyat प्रिया दशन छदात अन्यत स्वादु स्यात. कैन देयर एवर बी समथिंग विच इज मोर टेस्टी देन द प्रिया दशन छदः, मोर टेस्टी देन प्रिया बिलवड्स लिप्स. सो कैन देयर बी एनीथिंग मोर टेस्टी देन हर लिप्स? लेट अ पर्सन हु अंडरस्टैंड्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टेस्ट टेल मी. ओके वदतु. So shloka meaning is fine. Now the lakshanam here for this chandas is rasa yuga hayehi sau mrau slau go yada harini tada. Lakshanam goes like this: rasa yuga hayehi na sa ma ra sa lagu guru. Okay, if you look at this portion describes the ganas. Na gana, sa gana, ma ra sa, and then you have a lagu guru. Now that part has been satisfied perfectly in this vrittam. That's not an issue here. Now what is a yati? Yati gives a natural pause in the vrittam, making it beautiful for recitation. And it also gives us, for long vrittams, it is an easier way to, you know, there is a rhythm to that shloka. If you have yati, it is a natural pause, and that also helps in bringing out the rasam beautifully. It is not only in the lakshanam and lakshyam that is the problem that we need to look at. It also has an effect in the rasa, and that's why we are looking at vrittam also in detail. In dosham too. Here the yati, he says, is in rasa yuga hayehi. Rasaha shad rasaha yugani chatwari sapta cha hayaha. So there are seven horses for Surya. You take that into consideration and say sapta ashwaha. So shad rasaha chatwari yugam. Yugam is also, you have four yugas. So now that is where the yati goes. You take each varna, for example here, amrita ma mrita. So that is your six letters. You have a yati there. Amrita ma mritam kasandeho madhunyapi na anyatha. It gives us a nice way of reciting. It also makes the other person understand it beautifully. So that is why you have to have those natural pauses, which is called yati. Madhuram adhikam chutasyapi prasannarasam phalam sakridapi punar madhyastasann. It doesn't matter if there is a sandhi there, as long as you can finish that word at that point. ओके सकृदपि पुनर्मध्यस्थस्सन् रसान्तरविज्जनो वदतु यदिहा न्यत् स्वादु स्यात् दट् इस् वेर् यु हेव् अ प्राब्लम् वदतु यत् इह अन्यत् स्वादु स्यात् प्रिया दशनच्छदात् स्वादु स्यात् यत् प्रिया स्वादु स्यात् प्रिय सो दट् प्रिया दशनच्छदात् comes beautifully with seven letters and that yati comes after syat. So that works out pretty well. But here, your word does not end with vadatu yadihan. It does not end there. Nor does it end with vadatu yadiha. You cannot end it there. The yati comes in between the word. Okay, even if you split it, the problem is you cannot have a guru there. So your starting is na gana and sa gana, right? So na is, how is your na gana? Oh, sorry, where is this? Na gana is three lagu and sa has two lagu with one guru. Here you have three lagu and then you have two lagu with one guru. That one guru should be there. If you just split the word into vadatu yadiha anyat swadu syat, then you have an extra letter also there, which is again vritta is lost. The lakshana of the vritta is gone. And if you don't have that guru also there, then that also is a problem. Hence, you have, since you have the yati in the middle of that word, that is an issue. So he says in the text, अत्र यदिहान्यत् स्वादु स्यात् इति अश्रव्यम् ही एक्चुअली सेज दैट इट इज अश्रव्यम् यति इज ओनली इट इज नॉट इट इज लेट्स से इट इज नॉट टू कंडीशनल आई कांट से इट इज ऑप्शनल आल्सो बट इफ इट नेचुरली फॉलोज इन सच अ मैनर लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू टेक दैट Punar is a better way, even though you have made the sandhi and the next word has come, that punar is a natural pause that you can take at that point of time. And the yati, if you give that natural pause where the yati should be, then it is more easier. Here, it is not like that. Hence, it is ashravya. I am not able to take a natural pause there. Vadatu yadiha nyat swadu. Then there becomes a... it narrator, that is, I can't use a proper English word for that. It's tricky. Okay, now this is for varna vrittam. Next he takes up matra vrittam. Now matra vrittam, how you count matra vrittam is you again have your gana. Beyond that, you actually have to first count the matras. Where if when you took up this here, every whether it was a laghu or whether it was a guru, you counted it as one. Whereas in matra vrittam, all laghu will be considered as one, all guru will be considered as two. Even the laghu which is followed by a samyuktakshara, and since it is considered as guru, that will also be considered as two matra. It, the time it is it takes to pronounce the vowel, that is your matra. Kasandeha, it takes two matras for that. Amritam, amritam, there you have only 1, 2, 3, 4. So matra chandas is different counting and varna vrittam, vrittam is different counting. The next shloka he gives is an example for matra vrittam also, where there can be ashravyam. For the meaning of the shloka, let's take the Sanskritam version. Yat parihartum tiryate managapi na sundaratva gunena atha kevalam yasya doshaha pratipakshairapi pratipannaha. Yat parihartum tiryate managapi na sundaratva gunena. Sundaratva gunena yat managapi parihartum na tiryate atha kevalam yasya doshaha. Pratipakshairapi pratipannaha. So, someone is trying to say the futility of trying to win over Manmatha. So, It's like an Arthantra Nyasa where he says, Yat Sundaratva Gunayana, the effects of Manmatha, Kama, are so beautiful. Sundaratva Gunayana, because of its beauty, Parihartum, Managapi na Tiryate, na Paryate. It's very difficult to Parihartum, to remove the effects of love from one. It's very difficult to remove that Kama Avastha or Kama influence, Prabhava. Manmatha's influence from our mind, even slightly, it's very difficult to remove it. Why? The reason he gives is Sundaratva Gunena. He supports it with an example saying, Pratipakshairapi Pratipannaha Yasya Doshaha Kevalam. Yasya Doshaha Kevalam. See, it is the fault of Manmatha. Nobody can do anything about it because even Pratipaksha, Pratipaksha is a Shatru. Who is the Shatru of Manmatha? A yogi. Even yogis are unable to have felt the effect of Manmatha. They are unable to let go of those feelings. Even Shiva in Kumara Sambhava fell in love with Parvati and Manmatha had an effect on him. Right? Harastu kinchit pravirupta dhairyaha. That is the effect of him. Vishwamitra fell for Menaka and we had Shakuntala there. That is why we have the big epic drama Shakuntala. So even pratipakshairapi yogibirapi ye pratipakshes tishthanti yogibihi munibirapi pratipannaha anubhutaha. Even yogis have experienced its fault. So it is that Manmatha's fault. Atha kevalam yasya doshaha tam parihartum na tiryate. Pratipakshairapi saha pratipannaha yasya doshaha yasya Manmathasya doshaha kevalam sa manmataha pratipakshairapi sa kamaha pratipakshairapi pratipannaha jnataha. Even munibirapi, sages also know about this. Now the Prakritam verse, I don't know Prakritam, so I cannot teach it with the Prakritam. It is in Gatha Chandas. So the Matra also follows the Gatha Chandas, which is there in Prakritam, do not apply the Chandas or the Vritta Lakshanam in the Sanskritam version. You have to apply it only in the Prakritam version. Now, generally, for Matra Vrittam, you have to follow Gana. It's better to, there is a Gana for Matra Vrittam also. But first, let's look at the Lakshanam here. The Lakshanam is also given in Prakritam, so I have just taken the Sanskritam version of it. Yasyaha prathame charane dvadasha matraha bhavanti dvitiye ashtadasha bihi matra bihi samyukta bhavati yatha prathamam tatha tritiyam yacha chaturthe charane panchadasha matra bihi vibhushita sa gatha. Now if you count each gana, so the first padam, prathame pade, I think it stops with this part, right? So jam, you will count it as two matras, two, and then three, four, five, six, this is seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. It stops with this, okay? The next padam has one, two, three, four, here five, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Sundaratta is again a guru. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. No, I counted wrong. It's it should be 18 and there will be 18. Please take your time to count. Let's look at just the dosham here. The next Tritiya Padam will also have 12 matras. The last Padam will have 15 matras, which is Pushpitagra. Now here, you can use Gana. There is no issue. In fact, here he points out that this portion where I have underlined, the first one is Sagana and the next one is Bhagana. You can look at that Yamata Rajabhana Salaga. The same thing applies here also for that. Now here, the Sagana ends with the Guru letter and the Bhagana starts with the Guru letter. In Pushpitagram, and that too, if it is more of a Shringara Rasa Param or Vipralamba Shringara, in those cases, you use the Gatha Chandas for the ease of pronunciation and recitation. There is an ease to that recitation, and the way you say it has to be very sukumaratvam has to be there. When two guru letters are combined together, it is very difficult to hear. So he says it is tough. I'm just quoting what the commentators have said. Let's just take it with that. I have no experience with Prakritam meters to understand why it is like that and try to explain it more. So we'll move on to the next part. So for Ashravyam, Vritta Lakshana Anusarane Abhi, even though it follows the Vritta Lakshanam, it still is difficult to hear. So he gave the example of Varna Vrittam, Harini, and for the Matra Vrittam, he gave the example of Pushpitagra. The next is Aprapta Guru Bhava Anta Lagu. Now, I told you about how Lagu becomes a guru. Yes. What is the question? In the text, it says Ashravyam. You can also say it as Ashravyam. Ashravyam is what the text says. Ashravyam, tappilla, Ashravyam puru. It's difficult to hear. Ashravyam, na, it's difficult to say. It can't be difficult to say, no? Shravyam is Shravayitum Yogyam. I think Ashravyam is what we should take it as. Yeah, so Dvitiya Tritiya Ganau Sakara Bhakarau is what he has said for the previous shloka. The next one is Aprapta Guru Bhava Anta Lagu. Now, Va Padante is a rule that is there for Chanda Shastram, where in an Anta, Padantam, Pada Antam, Prathama, every shloka has four padas, and one pada at the end of a padam, if there is a lagu, it can be treated as a guru. So va padante, it can va. So there is an optional optionality given. If the gana dictates that there should be a guru letter at that point, then you can treat even a lagu letter, which is at the end of a pada, as a guru. Okay. Now in this is Pushpitagra. Oh, did I mention that the earlier one was Pushpitagram? Sorry, the last shloka was Gatha Chandas. This one is only Pushpitagra. Pushpitagra is an Ardha Samavrittam. So generally, Samavrittam means all four padas have the same number of varna. Samavrittam, Asamavrittam is each pada has different varnas. Here, Ardha Samavrittam is only half of it is samam. You can have 1 and 2 sama, 2 and 4, 3 and 4 sama. That is, they follow the same pattern. Or you can have 1 and 3 following the same pattern and 2 and 4 following the same pattern. Okay. Now, the lakshanam for Pushpitagra. Oh, let's look at the meaning of the shlokam and then go there. Vikasita sahakara tara hari parimala gunjita punjita dvirephaha. Navakisalaya Charu Chamara Shrihi Harati Munehe Api Manasam Vasantaha. Very similar to the shloka that he said before, where he said the effects of Manmatha cannot be overcome. Here he says the effects of Vasantaratu cannot be overcome by even a muni. Even a sage's mind is being attracted by the Vasantaratu. Vasantaha, spring. Munehe manasam api harati. Munehe api manasam harati. Katham asti vasantaha. Two visheshanas given here. One is vikasita sahakara tara hari parimala gunjita punjita dvirephaha. There are two adjectives actually for vasanta in that one samastapadam. The first one is vikasita sahakara tara hari parimala. The mango trees are all vikasitam. It is bloomed. Vikasita, sahakara, sahakara chuta. Tara, hari. It's very beautiful. Tara is atishayena hari manoharam. So tara hari, atishayena manoharaha, sahakara vrikshaha, katham kimartham pushpitamasti. So vikasitam sahakaram, tara hari, tadrishaha vasantaha. The next one is Parimala Gunjita Punjita Dvirepaha. Because of the sweet smell that comes from the bloom, the flowers that have bloomed everywhere, the Dvirepa, Bhramara, all the bees are all Punjita. It is clustering around the flowers, and it is Gunjitam Ringaram. Humming, the humming of the bees because of the sweet smell that comes out of the flowers that have bloomed. So the tadrasha bhramara yuktaha vasantaha. The third one he says, navakisalaya charu chamara shrihi. It has a beauty, shrihi. You know, if you look at Rajarajeshwari, the way he describes in Sandarlahari is sachamara ramavani Sabya Dakshina Sevita. Rama and Vani, Lakshmi and Saraswati are standing beside Rajarajeshwari on both sides, Lalitambika, and they are shaking that chamaram. They're doing that chamara seva for her. So it is that beauty there is associated with that chamaram. This is even for Vasanta, it is like that. The chamaram here is Nava Kisalaya Charu Chamara Shrihi. The new sprouts, new leaves that are there in the different trees, and the trees are all shaking with that Malaya Marutam. There is a slight breeze that is there, and the trees have new leaves, and it is shaking its hand, its branches. It is as if the Vasanta Ritu has a chamaram for it. Someone is doing the chamara seva for it, and it's so beautiful. So Shrihi, when this scene is there present in front of a sage, even he cannot but be attracted. Shloka is very nice. Vikasita sahakara tara hari parimala gunjita punjita dvirepaha. Now let's look at the lakshanam of Pushpitagra. Ayuji na yuga repha repataha yakaraha yuji cha najau jaragaha Pushpitagra, Jaragascha Pushpitagra. It is an Ardha Samavrittam, so Ayuji. Ayuji means in Vishama Padas. Vishama Padas, that is in the odd number of stanzas, which is the first and the third. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, in that the odd number of stanzas have one format, which is na na ra ya. It follows that format of gana. And in the second and chaturtha padam, you have na ja ja ra, and then gu. Gu is a representation of just one extra guru letter. Everything else will be split into 3, 3, 3, 3, and then if there is an extra, you just name it as lagu or guru at the end. So there you have na ja ja ra and gu for the second and the fourth pada. The 2, 3 and 4 have no issues, whereas here in the first padam, if you find, you have the optional rule, the exception which says va padante, where the Chanda Shastra allows that, and padanta laghu varna can be treated as guru, not an issue. So it follows the lakshanam, where in the first you have, I have split it into 3, 3, 3, where you have na, na, ra and yagana. In the yagana, Yamata, you are supposed to have a lagu, guru and guru. Instead of the guru, you have the ri, which is a hraswa letter, and it is not followed by a samyuktakshara for it to have a gurutvam. But luckily it is in the padantam, so you can call it as guru. It has a guru lakshana, not an issue. The what is the dosham that he is trying to point out is, when you recite the shloka again, see, it is more of in a kavyam, how you recite, how the flow, how the rhythm of that goes is more in the sahrdaya manas. That's why we look at the vyakhyanam for all these shlokas. We are not at that stage to just understand on our own whether it is fine or not. That's why we look at it. So he says, vikasita sahakara tara hari parimala. The whole thing, when it goes like that, there is no pause, there is no natural, whereas in the second you will find navakisalaya charu chamara shrir harati muner api manasam vasantaha. There is a natural pause there, it breaks there, and you're able to break it at that point of time, and there is a tightness to that meter. Whereas in the first, you have Bandha Shaitilyam, and even though Ant Aprapta Guru Bhavam, that Guru Bhavam, even though Gurutvam Praptam, you can say, but still Guru Bhavam Na Praptam. I am not able to feel that Guru Bhavam at the end of the first Pada. So Mamata suggests a different reading where he says, Vikasita Sahakara Tara Hari Pramudita Saurabha Punjita Dvirepaha. That's how it should have been, he says. And it again becomes a guru when you use Hari Pramudita. Yeah. Okay. So even though, just take it like that, even though there is a laghu and the laghu can become a guru, there is no, if it is at the end of a second pada or end of a fourth pada, then it is fine. That also depends on how the rest of the shloka goes. So for that, he takes, usually the end of the first padam is difficult because the shloka is continuous and you usually stop at the end of the second pada, and so it is difficult to pronounce. Whereas if it is at the end of the second pada or the fourth pada, where you have the one full stop and the double full stop, then it is easier, even if it is a laghu letter. Even that is a problem. And the next example he gives is in Chardula Vikriditam, where at the end there is a cha. I will explain the dosha first so that it's easier. So here the cha as a follow-up for the earlier shloka. If since it is at the end of the fourth pada, it again has to be a guru, but instead of a guru, it is a laghu, and that laghu has become guru. You can treat it as guru because it is in the padanta. Even then, the bandha shaitilyam is there. Let's look at the shlokam. Anyastaha guna ratna rohana bhuvaha dhanya mridanyaivasa sambhara kalute anya eva vidhina yairesha srishto yuva shrimat kanti jusham dusham karatalat strinam nitambastalat drishte yatra patanti moodha manasam astrani vastrani cha. If there was a break in the samasa after hari, would that have averted the dosha? In the previous shloka. Okay. If there was a break in the samasa after hari, then it would have been harihi. Correct? So you could have taken it as, let's see how that shloka is. Harif Parimala Gunja Gunjita Punjita Dvirepaha. Yes, I think you could have taken it like that. Then it would have been better. It still has to get that guru, is what I feel. Yeah. Unmute yourself. Oh, I have to. Chula?
Okay. Suppose now, just romba, suppose Vasantaha Napum Sakalingatla, and it would have been Hari.
Yeah.
Kasita Sahakarata, somehow Vasanta is Vasantam for some reason. Hari in Vandadana, is it still wrong? Like, Tani Vartayarde. And it's only taking Gurutvam because it's Padanta Laghu.
It is, Adana, see, the Padanta Guru, I feel, is more ideal if it is there in second and fourth Padam. If it is there in the first and the third, because it is continuous and it doesn't get that, and the Bandha Dardhyam is absent.
So, it's okay in like Itihasam, but maybe not in Kavyam, Andha Madri, Ramayana.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think you can do that. In some cases, it is fine. It's not such a big deal. So it's okay. As long as there is that dardhyam, then it's okay. That's what you have to take it as. We've not seen so much of Pushpitagra Chandas with this example. Yeah. Shardula Vikriditam is more understandable, it's easier. So, Anyastaha Guna Roha Ratna Rohana Bhuvaha. So, here he is talking about a Raja. Someone is praising a king who is both looked upon by his enemies and by ladies in favorably. When Shatrus look at this king, they drop their weapons. When ladies look at him, they are not even conscious of the cloth that is there on them. So he's just praising the king. He says, Anyaha taha guna ro ratna rohana bhuvaha. I don't know from where vidina yaihi sambaraha te anyeva yaihi yeshaha srishtaha. Yeshaha yuva yaihi srishtaha. 1 minute. I think I'll have to stop with this. This shloka itself is big. Let me take this up next week. I have to go now. Okay.